I don't care what my third grade school teacher said. I have great character. What's going on, PD peeps? You know this is Tablet Tuesday, so that means I gotta show you how to do the character intro effect using the PowerDirector Mobile Video Editor app. If you're new to my channel and you wanna learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Here we are in the PowerDirector app. The character intro allows you to add a dynamic effect to your video whenever you bring a new character on screen. The effect has been used in many motion pictures, and now, with a little help from your PD professor, you'll be able to use it in your videos. Let's bring some character into the situation. We're going to start off by bringing our clip into the timeline. Now, I'm going to use the overlay track because the overlay track allows us to use motion keyframes, which we're going to need later on. So you want to tap the overlay icon. You want to tap the video tab. You want to go to the location where your video is. You want to pick the video that you want to use. And then you want to tap on the plus sign, and it'll add it to your timeline right where your playhead is. Now you want to tap the clip that's on the timeline, and you want to go ahead and use two fingers to pinch this out to fill in the screen. Then you want to go ahead and tap on back. And we got our video in our timeline. The next thing that you want to do is create your freeze. So you want to move your playhead to the position where you want the freeze to take place. You want to tap on the clip, and you want to go ahead and tap on split. Now you need to take a screenshot of the video so that you can use it to create the freeze. So on many of your Android devices, you're going to hold down the power key and the volume down button, and it'll take a quick screenshot. You can tap on crop. And then if it does auto crop like mine, you can just tap on the little blue box. And then you want to go ahead and tap on save. And it'll save it to the screenshots on your device. Now you want to go ahead and add the screenshot in between these two clips. So you want to tap on the overlay icon again. This time you want to tap on the image tab. And you want to go to screenshots. You want to find a screenshot that you want to use, tap on it, and tap the plus sign, and it'll add it to your timeline right where your playhead is. But then you got to drag this in between the two clips. So you want to hold your finger on the screenshot until you get a yellow border and drag it up, let it go, and it'll put itself right in between those two clips and move the second clip over to the right. Now you want to go ahead and tap on the screenshot. And once again, you want to pinch out so that it fills out the screen. Now you want to go ahead and tap on the second part of the video. So this clip, we need to bring it down so that it's not so long. And we're going to trim the end of this. Hold our finger over the end. And then we're going to trim this in to make this clip about 2 seconds long. And then we're going to tap on the timeline anywhere where it's empty. And we'll play this back, and I'm going to show you how the freeze frame looks. But we ain't done yet, people. Now I want to change the freeze frame to black and white, because when it freezes, I want it to say, bam, change it to black and white, adds a little bit of impact to the clip. So I'm going to tap on the freeze frame portion in the middle, the screenshot that we created, and I'm going to tap on adjustments, and I'm going to tap on saturation, and I'm going to bring the saturation slider all the way down to zero, and now we've got black and white. So now I'm going to tap back. So now I want to create a zoom in and zoom out. And in order to do that, we're going to need to use keyframes. So I already have my playhead at the beginning of the freeze frame clip. So at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and tap on transform keyframe. And I'm going to tap on this diamond. And this will lock in the position right where it is. But now I want to create that zoom. So I'm going to move my playhead about 6 units in to 2.6. And at this point, I'm going to go ahead and change the scale. So I'm going to use two fingers and I'm going to move them out so that I bring up the scale. And then if you want to, you can change the position as well. And as you can see, it created a keyframe for the scale X and Y position that I changed it to. So now you can go ahead and tap on back. And now you want to tap on split. So we created a little zoom in at that point. So now we want to create a zoom out as well. So we're going to move our playhead to a position where we want to go ahead and zoom out. And then we're going to go ahead and tap on split clip. We're going to tap on transform keyframe. We're going to tap on this diamond to lock it in at this position. And then we're going to go ahead and move this to the end of this clip. And we're going to scale it back down to the original size. So your scale should be a 1. And then you should move the X and a Y back to a 5, 501, 502, however close you can get it. Be truthful with you, it's not going to be perfect, but it's okay. And it should go ahead and create a keyframe at this position as well. So now we want to make sure that the freeze frame in the middle is a bit smaller. Could be kind of long right now when you look at it, and we're looking at about 4 seconds, something like that. So I want to move it back to 3 seconds. So that'll be 5.6. And that's pretty good there. Then we want to go ahead and drag these to the position that they need to be in. I'm going to hold down my finger over till it turns yellow. If you can't do that, you can drag out and make your timeline a little bit bigger. Then drag it over into position. It'll lock itself in. Do the same thing with the second one. Hold your finger over until you get that yellow border. Drag it over, let it go, and everything should be in place at this point. So now let's go ahead and look at the zoom. Good to go. So the next thing that we want to do is you want to go ahead and add your title. I'm going to tap on this first part of the zoom of the freeze frame so that my playhead is right at the beginning. Then I'm going to tap on the overlay icon. I'm going to make sure that I'm in the title tab. And I'm going to find the title that I want to use. I'm going to tap on it. I'll tap the plus sign. And it will go ahead and add it to the timeline on the overlay track. And I just want the title to be over the zoom section. So I'm going to tap on it. Hold my finger over the end. And I'm going to drag it in. It should lock into place. And now it's just covering this section here. I'm going to place my playhead somewhere where I can see the entire title. And then I'm going to go ahead and move the title over to where I want it to be when it comes on the screen. Then I'm going to tap on edit. And right now it's set to vintage title. So I'm going to change that. And I'll tap on the check mark. And it changed the name. Then I'm going to tap on a little drop down arrow here. I'm going to pick the other part of the text. I'll tap on edit. I'll change that text. Now I'll tap on the check mark. Now I'll tap on the timeline and we'll play it back and see what it looks like.
That was an impressive introduction. If you like what you see, I'll leave a link to try out PowerDirector Mobile in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.